Good afternoon, everybody. We're very excited to play for everybody in this really stunning place, and playing earlier here today, realized how much fun it's going to be with the sound, so we hope you enjoy it as much as we are. The first piece we're going to play is from the last group of six that Haydn wrote for quartet. Really straight after that, Beethoven started writing quartets, and I guess Haydn just decided there was no point anymore. And it's really interesting because in this group of quartets, he really tried to push the envelope of what you can do with the standard tools that composers had at the time. So he wasn't inventing new tools, but he was just using what he had and made really, really awkward and funny and dramatic inventions. One of them was using the circle of fifths as a theme in the first movement. In the second movement, he pulls back a bit and kind of gets a little bit lyrical with a nice accompaniment by the rest of the quartet, and the theme kind of jumps back between the variations in the first violin and the pizzicato in the rest of the group. The third movement is sort of a straight minuet and trio, but not in a way that we're used to. He's using an old tool of writing in canon, and with a very devilish witch's dance that gets handed back and forth between the groups. And in the last movement, you'll hear something very typical for Haydn, because he really liked to make a classical, elegant quartet sound like folk or gypsy music. And it really goes far in the last movement in that regard. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
The next quartet you're going to hear is from that first set of six that Beethoven wrote not far after Haydn wrote his last. It's also his last set of six. It took him a long time to write it, many sketches, many trials, in order to get to the final version that he liked for the whole set as a group. I guess it took too much energy out of him, and he decided it's much better, in his opinion, for him to go on a more epic journey in quartets and write less pieces, but with more material and a bigger, more epic kind of feel to it. In this quartet, out of the whole group of six, it's, in a way, the most Beethoven-y quartet and the least, because he has a lot of nods into the style that Haydn wrote in. So you'll see a lot of attempts to portray an ambience of elegance, but at the same time to really kind of zing into it and find where he can put his Beethoven touch into it. The first movement is a very simple dance with many, many surprises in it. In the second movement, you'll find a minuet and trio with a nice elegant Ländler in it, some harmonic surprises in it. The third movement is a theme and variations. The theme is very simple, naive, almost choir-like or children's choir maybe, something of that sort. But every variation gets further and further away from that character up until to the very last variation before the coda, where it almost sounds like you're going to a circus. The last movement is very fiery, very fast, very dramatic, but at the same time ends in such a surprising way that it almost sounds like it's a mistake. I think you can imagine to yourselves, if he wanted that kind of effect of the quartet can just move on in your imagination, or he wanted that shock and awe of ending something really quiet and elegant, almost in the middle of a phrase. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.